Most Hasidic community members are too afraid to speak out about the poor education of their children's schools because they fear being threatened by Hasidic leaders, losing their jobs, and permanently damaging their families' reputations and lives. Here, five former New York Hasidic school students bravely open up about their own experiences in the hopes of making a change in the lives of today's Hasidic children.
At the age of 37, when I tried enrolling in community college, I was placed into ESL, English as a second language, where the instructor asked me at what age I immigrated, which is exactly what being robbed of an education did to me. It made me an immigrant in my own country.
The boys in the community received even less than I did. They are often unable to communicate in the English language, and they are sort of like immigrants in their own country.
I was in sixth grade when my English teacher stumbled upon the word Asia in the textbook, not knowing how to pronounce the word, let alone what it means. I and another classmate of mine, who, like me, was being taught at home by his father, we had to teach the teacher that it's pronounced Asia and that it's a continent.
Youngest son is 7 years old in Hasidic yeshiva, and I see him headed in the same direction. I try to supplement his learning at home, and I see the distance between what he's being taught in school and what his grade level actually is getting larger and larger.
On behalf of the tens of thousands of kids who are currently attending these yeshivas, I urge you to vote in favor of the regulations so that no other child has to live through my terrible experience.
How much longer are we supposed to wait for all children, regardless of where they come from, to receive an adequate secular education so they can tap into the potential